beers, but it still goes to show that T1 does have the much higher hands there, 14-4 when it does come to games played, as we'll also take a look at some of the highlights from the games that they did play here in the 2020 spring split.
And if you guys recall, the last time that these two collided, Genji sort of fell apart really early on and could never really stabilize. And I don't expect something of that nature to happen again here in tonight's series. But T1, it is going to be pretty interesting, especially the way that they drafted in the series against DRX. I think that we could have much more stable games without that kind of volatility that could end up happening, as Genji, again, what do they have in store for us here tonight? Because if it's going to end up like the last series, that could be some bad news bears.
That is true. The last couple of series they have played, and a lot of the other series they have played in the last 2 years, have all been losses to T1. And so they are going to have to change something up here, as you can see that the mechanics from all the players on both teams, quite impressive as we slow down a lot of the big team fights that we do have from the best of threes that we did have from 2020 spring. I thought it was very poignant that one of the highlights we saw there was Ruler flashing to kill Faker in the first one. Brings back memories from Worlds. As we do take a look here, just rounding out some of the highlights. So we see the Zillion and the Galio being played multiple times here by BDD. You talked about special picks. We might have to see that from BDD if he wants to try to carry his team. Ruler also a big name carry for his team, and had a fun time picking up a quadra kill this time around.
And, you know, we heard Ambition refer to BDD difference could be one of the deciding factors, and BDD has been sort of doing everything in a lot of the games this split for Genji. It's been really integral. I mean, he won the MVP. And the other thing about Genji is that as a unit, it feels like there's so much cohesion, but BDD is really the general in a lot of the team fights and a lot of the deciding plays that end up happening and unfolding inside of their team. He's been phenomenal on Azir this split, and I know many consider Azir to be the best mid laner in the meta right now. However, we've also seen BDD pull out the Vel'Koz, and that is one of the answers to Azir. So I'm looking forward to seeing that here tonight.
하면 20초.
20초.
아, 오케이, 끝날 것 같아.
아, 20초야. 웨이브 너무 끝나. 웨이브 너무 끝나. 타워. 웨이브부터, 웨이브부터.
웨이브. 파즈 잡을게.
타워, 타워.
나중에 들어온다. 이제 아주 들어온다. 아주 좋냐.
퍼져, 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 퍼져.
타워 하나 남았다.
웨이브 지워, 웨이브 지워봐.
야, 싸움 보자, 싸움
보자. 야, 앞에, 앞에, 앞에.
그만해.
야, 점프할게, 점프다, 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 점프다,
점프다, 점프다,
점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다,
점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다,
점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다, 점프다,